it's Lori Ballen here in Las Vegas. Today, our video, which is part of the 365 days of KW Command videos that I make, we're going to do a postcard today, and we're going to use direct mail. So from our home screen, what we're going to do is we're going to go down to campaigns, and then we're going to click create new campaign, direct mail. So give your direct mail a name. In my case, I'm just going to put direct mail sample. And what are we wanting to do? Are we wanting to do a postcard to advertise a listing, attract listings, attract talent? We can choose one of those. And down here, how would you like to create your campaign? Default templates provided or upload a custom template? Let's go with default templates provided and click set up a campaign. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is we're going to go ahead and do one for a listing. Okay, you don't have to do it for a listing. You can close this box out and do something completely different. But let's go ahead and do it for a listing. So you can find a listing by property address, by MLS number, or by listing agent. I'm going to select to show all listings. And I will put in Krista. Let's see if Krista has anything in there today. Okay, so let's say we want to do a postcard on Krista Porter. She's an agent on my team on 5605 Blue Peak Avenue. So we're going to click select. Okay, so now if I want to rename this, because I know I'm going to do 5605 Blue Peak, I can still do that here. Most of the time you can change anything after the fact. So don't panic about what you're choosing on the front end of this. So see here, what is your goal? Advertise listing, attract listings. You can change that here. And at this point, I believe that's more for KW Command tracking purposes than anything else. So we've got that in there. We're gonna save the name and the goal. Okay, now the listing photo. Which of these photos do you want to be on your postcard? There we go. So you see how they populate there. That's pretty. So pick the one you want. I rarely do front of the house because in Vegas, all of our houses look alike. So rarely is the front of the house the best picture. Usually it's an inside picture with the kitchen, and that's actually really pretty. I like that. She got some nice pictures here. Okay, so once you choose your picture, click save. And it will tell you if it's a low resolution picture. It's still up to you if you want to go ahead and use the picture that is here, or you can upload and replace an image. So let me go to upload and replace an image, and let me pull her original pictures here. Blue Peak. Hold on 1 second. Let me find them. All right, here's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to grab a picture here. For some reason, I can't find the original file. And I'm going to click open, and we'll just go with this one for our demo. Okay, so see how the error message disappears when you have a high resolution image. Okay. So that is a choice in what you want to use there for your pictures. I have not tested this myself to compare the higher resolution with the print, but in most cases, I think our general web images would work fine. So you'll have to test that and decide how you like it best. And then I'm going to click save. And then next we have the agent. All right, so agent says Krista Porter. So if I wanted this to all be Krista's information, that's fine. It's not pulling her photo, so let me grab Krista's photo. Okay, you can adjust the crop however you want to. Let's just do the headshot there. Okay, and then click save. Next, we have Market Center. So Market Center, she is with my team, my office, Keller Williams Realty, Las Vegas. It is not pulling the address, so let's do that. Let's see. 9420 West Sahara, Suite 100. Eight nine 117, and DBA logo. I think it already puts that in there. I'm not going to add it right now, but I could put my team logo there. We'll see how that looks. Try that crop right there. Okay. All right. We'll see how that looks on the card there. And then we've got our office address. So let's click verify address 9420. Okay. There we go. Corrected address. That looks good. It added the +4 zip. Next, we have targeting. So who do we want to get that database? So you can choose people in your database by tags or by individual contact. Let's do local targeting and send it to the homes right around that home. So we're gonna click save. And now we're gonna choose our budget. So 200 postcards, first class mail, budget estimate $118. If you click it, you can open it and you can say, I wanna send this to 500 homes right around that home. And I'm willing to pay $295 for first class. So whatever it is that you want to send there, choose your budget. Now we'll go over to the right-hand side. Now this is priced based on 4x6 postcards. If you want this to be the large 6x9, you'll change that here and you'll notice your budget will change down here. See that? The KW Modern template is 6x11 at 89 cents standard. And KW Contemporary Template. I actually really like that one. I like these ones that have the picture all the way across, those big wide ones. They look so good. So it depends on what I'm sending, but for this kind of a house, I would be willing to increase my budget to send that personally. All right, do you want it to have a QR code for tracking? And if so, it'll print a QR code on the postcard. And then you can choose a landing page that they, when they scan the QR code, they would then go to a landing page that you created on your website. So you would go in and create a landing page for this listing. I have another video that shows you how to make a landing page for listing. So you would first make your landing page, and then it would show up in here. So you say, yes, add the QR code for tracking. And this is where I want them to go when they scan it to find out more about that property. Okay? So it's a call to action. It's like a direct response for them to do something to get something. Okay? All right. And then let's preview our postcard. That is gorgeous. I really, really like it. Okay, so my logo does not quite look right, does it? Let me see if that's, yeah, I'd have to change that. And I need this to fit my brokerage requirements. So I would need to go back and change. Let me see what the other designs look like. Hold on, let's try the 4x6. Okay, so what I would do is I go, yeah, it doesn't look right. Let me go change that DBA logo. There's the agent, Market Center. Okay. So just recommended size is 600 by 600. So let me see what the DBA logo looks like here. Okay, let's click save and preview. That is still cutting it off. Okay, I like this design overall better. So here's what I'm going to do to see if that logo will fit. I'm going to go to Canva, which is my where I do a lot of my designs for all of my different businesses. Custom dimensions, 600 by 600. And then I am going to do my logo, which is folders, logos, right there. Download. I'm not sure if I want a transparent background or not. Let me try it. So transparent background will remove that white box. KW 600 by 600 transparent. All right, now let's go. So we'll go back down to Market Center and upload and replace image. Now, if you create this in design first, you can actually upload your design. Might be easier than this. This is the first time I did one like this, so. Learning on the fly. Oh, that looks good. Okay, save. Now let's check it out. Preview postcard. Ah, much better. Now, I wonder, is it not letting me add any other text? So my challenge, I'm just going to share with you, my challenge with this would be broker requirements. I don't see the option to add text. And we have to put our license number. Let me see under agent if I can... I wonder if I could put, let me just try something. Krista Porter S. That's not really her license number, but we're going to just check it. That would work. That would work. So what I did is I just added the license number to her last name, and that works there. I've got my Keller Williams Las Vegas logo. That's required. I've got her address. That's required. So front and back. So my two cents on this as I'm reviewing this whole thing is that when you configure using their template, it's not hard, and it's easier not to mess up. At the same time, you don't have a lot of editing ability. So if you don't like the way it looks, you're kind of stuck. So that would be my personal thing. Okay, so let's go do one, like if we're uploading one. We did all of this. Your next step, if you've completed everything, is to configure targeting. Let's finish walking this all the way through. Say yes. So we've done our postcard. Please wait while we connect you with real mailers. So it is still real mailers. Okay, here we go. I love this part. So targeting, number of homes to target. So we're gonna say 200. Property type, single family or multifamily. So if you want apartments to get it, you can include multifamily. If you only want people who live in houses to get it, then we'll just do single family, okay? And then if you care at all about the size of the home those people live in now, you can narrow that down. These are gonna be better for like when you're targeting for listings and you want a particular type of house that you're listing, or you want them to have lived in the house for a certain amount of time. But if I'm just doing, I wanna market this listing, I'm gonna hit everybody in the general area, okay? So standard mail of first class, send a copy to company address. So click there if you want to get a copy of that as well. And then here's your total. Now I'm not gonna click next because I'm afraid it's gonna bill me. And I haven't gone all the way through this yet. Make sure it's the way I wanna mail it. So I'm gonna leave it like this. Okay, now let me show you how to do this if we're gonna upload a postcard that we made in designs. Okay, so here's a postcard that I made in designs for our first video. What we need to do now is we need to download the front and the back. So we're going to go to download. You have to choose get PDF. I'm going to download current design, high resolution print quality, use manual bleed. So those are the items that are in the instructions that they want us to use for KW Command. So then I click start download and I'm going to download the front. So in a moment, it's going to pop up and it's going to give me the option to download the postcard front. So I'm just going to put front right now so I can find it real quick. And then we're going to do the same thing here, download. And we need to download the back now. So click on the back. Now we go up here to download. Same settings, start download, get PDF. And when it pops up, I'm just going to give it the title back so I can find it again real quick. Perfect. Okay. So now, just like we did before, we're going to go to, sorry about that, hopping around. Okay, direct mail. Here we go. So we're going to go to create a campaign, direct mail. Sample two. We are advertising a listing, and I'm going to upload a custom template, setup campaign. Now we have the ability to drag and drop a browse file. So upload, and I'm going to do the front. You see where it says front of postcard. Then we're going to go to back of postcard and back PDF. So the design was already a 4x6. So you can see here it's accepting it as a 4x6. Click continue. There's your postcard. So you would go through all of those same steps. And then when you preview it, see how much better that looks? I think that looks so much better. The one that we just made in designs. And this was just sloppy sampling there, but it looks so much cleaner, I think. So my personal preference is to create the design because you have much more flexibility with your text, what you want on the picture, how you want your branding, where you want the logo to show up. So many more designs and options. And it's actually very easy to just download it in the correct PDF format and then upload it and off you go. That just seems so much easier. So personally, I really like this idea of sending the postcards this way. It makes it easy. You've got it all in one system. And we'll talk more about targeting the database in another video. But this is perfect for those hyperlocal. Let me just hit 200 homes right around that address or larger if you've got an area around there and then send that postcard. I'm Lori Ballen with 365 Days of Command and would very much appreciate your referrals for Las Vegas, Henderson, and North Las Vegas, Nevada.